This is third lecture on diodes, and in today's class we shall talk about this clipper circuit, and we shall also talk about the clampers one. Okay. In today's class I have shown you that if there is a ripple of level in a digital signal just like this. So, if ripple is there on the top of this digital waveform, okay, then how it is cleaned up. So, for that we can design a circuit, clipper circuit, and that clipper circuit basically cleaned up the ripple which is there on the top of the waveform. Okay. Similarly, if you have a digital signal like this, let us say that it is a bipolar signal, and there are three allowed levels in this digital signal. One is here, another one may be 0, and then minus 1. Okay, that means you can say here that this is voltage level E, this one is minus E, and 0 level is also there. I have told you that a digital signal may have even more than 2 levels. Okay, until or unless the levels are finite. I mean, if the levels are finite, then it is said to be a digital signal. Okay. So, in this case you see that there are 3 levels. One level is plus E, another one is minus E, and this is 0. Okay. So, if for example, let us say that there is a noise signal here, somehow this signal during the transmission has caught this noise portion, this can also be eliminated by using by designing a suitable clipper circuit. Okay. And to eliminate this circuit, we can have this simple circuit which can do this elimination. I will have two diodes connected in parallel but in opposite direction, and the resistance R as usual. Okay. So, Vi and V naught. Okay. And let us say that their forward voltage drop is Vf plus Vf, Vf for this D1 and again Vf for D2. Okay. One thing you should note here, that this fluctuation here, this ripple which is undesirable, that should not cross that Vf level. Okay. It should be confined between plus minus Vf. If this is plus minus Vf, that can be eliminated by this circuit. Okay. How it can be done? You see that if the input signal level is less than Vf, okay, in that case you can see that both diodes are, I mean, if the input signal is in this range, if Vi is between minus Vf to plus Vf, in this case both diodes D1 and D2 remain in off state. Okay. And in this case there will be no signal transmission to the output nodes. So, output will be 0. Okay. So, for this case, if there is any variation, but the variation less than plus minus Vp, you see that output remains 0 in that case. And therefore, for this portion you will get 0 at the output, and thus the fluctuation, 0 level fluctuation can be cleaned up easily by using this circuit. Okay. So far I have shown you that a clipper circuit clips either the whole positive portion or negative portion. Okay, but it's not true. You can design a circuit which will selectively clip of a particular signal. You can selectively clip of a positive portion of a signal or a negative portion of a signal, or a portion of positive or a portion of negative can also be clipped off by making a suitable design. Okay. So, just look at this circuit. Yeah. here I have a resistance R1 and two diodes let's say VB1 and here we have another level VB2 or you can say this is VB, this one is minus VB and this one is our output. Output is taken between this plus and minus, input is given here. Okay. Let's say that our input is a sinusoidal signal in this case like this. Okay. So, see what will be the output in this case? This is the example of a selective clipping. Okay. By this circuit you can clipped up both positive and negative portion of the sinusoidal waveform. Okay. You can use one diode just to clip one portion. Okay. You can clip up positive or negative portion by selecting one or this or this diode in the circuit. Okay. So, this is a more general circuit and the working principle for this circuit is very simple. You see here that in this case if I look at this node, okay, then you will see that if the potential of this node is greater than VB plus VF, okay, let us say that the drop here across this diode is VF. So, if the potential at this node goes above VB plus VF, then this diode becomes on, okay, and whenever this diode becomes on, the output at this node is going to be VB plus VF, okay. There will be no change in the output further, even if the potential here tries to go higher than that previous value, I mean VB plus VF level, okay. Getting this point? Because if the diode is on, the potential across this diode is VF, okay, and in that case the potential here is VF plus VB, VF plus VB, that is fixed. So, as long as this diode is in on condition, potential here remains VF plus VB, okay. And just look at the another case when the potential at this node try to goes below VF minus VF plus VB, okay. Just think about what will happen if the potential here try to goes below minus VB plus VF, then what will happen? This diode will be in on condition and on condition means the output at this node is going to be now minus VB plus VF, okay. And now if even the input signal here goes below minus VB plus VF, in that case the output here remains constant and that will be minus VB plus VF, okay. That means as long as the potential at this node is smaller than that of this node by VF magnitude, okay, this diode remains in on condition and if it is in on condition, voltage here is going to be minus VB plus VF, okay. Similarly, as long as this remains in on condition, voltage here will be VB plus VF, okay. And what will be the output potential if the input voltage is in between? If the potential here is in between minus VB plus VF to VB plus VF, both diode will be in off condition and off condition means whatever you will apply here as a input that will appear at the output terminal, okay. Is it making sense? So, in this case you will see your output voltage will be something like this, it will appear like this. You will see that some portion is clipped off, positive portion, similarly its negative portion is clipped off. This level is actually VB plus VF and this level is minus VB plus VF, okay. Is it clear? It is pretty simple. Okay. It is simply based on the concept that when the diode will be in on condition, the potential drop across the diode is Vf. Okay. And in this case, either you measure potential taking this one as a reference or this one as a reference, in both case will have the same potential. Okay. So, that is why I am measuring the potential at this node starting from this point, because it is very easy to measure. This is fixed at Vb level, Vb plus Vf, that is the potential of this node. If this is on, or when this is on, then potential here minus Vb plus Vf. Okay. Making sense? And similarly, you can either choose D1, let me call it D1 or D2 to have only positive or negative clipping. Okay. If you want positive clipping only, you want negative portion to remain intact, then what you will do? You will select this D1. Okay. Don't use this D2. Or you can have for negative clipping, you can have this D2, you can remove D1. Okay. It is a general circuit. Is it clear? And please note that in somewhere you will find the circuit like this. Both are similar circuit. Okay. So, again, what is there? In this case, the cathode is kept at this potential, whatever it is. It is 2 volt, then this is at 2 volt. Okay. So, make it use this battery here or remove this battery and show here only Vb or 2 volt, both are same. Okay. So, difference of notation only. Okay. So, this was the selective clipping of a signal. Now, you should know that Zener diode, a very useful diode, is also used for clipping of a waveform. Okay. So, before going to use that Zener diode in a clipper circuit, let me give a brief idea about the Zener diode, how actually it works. Okay. Actually, I will not discuss the working principle, but I will point out that important characteristics of Zener diode which is going to be used here. Okay. So, for a Zener diode, basically is operated in the reverse bias condition. It is a specially made diode where both P and N side are very, very highly doped. Doping level remains very high, and because of that high doping level, tunneling takes place across the barrier, potential barrier, and there will be a flow of current. Okay. So, if we apply a high reverse bias potential across that PN junction diode, we will observe that when this potential reaches to a certain value, there is a sudden change in the current. Okay. Just like the forward characteristics of the diode, but the only difference is the Vf, forward voltage drop, is 0.6 or 0.7 volt, but this phenomena happens at very high reverse bias voltage. For example, 5 volt or 6 volt, something like that. Okay. So, if this phenomena takes place at 5 volt, it is said that the breakdown voltage for the Zener diode is 5 volt. Okay. Or if it is at 6 volt, you will see that the breakdown will be at 6 volt. When you will have a Zener diode, the rating is written on the diode. If 5 is written, you should think that its breakdown voltage is 5 volt on a Zener diode. Okay. So, the point to note here is, if the applied potential, if a Zener diode, the symbol for Zener diode is like this. Okay. So, slightly different from the ordinary diode, here we put Z symbol. Z stands for Zener diode. Okay. For ordinary diode, it is to be like this. Okay. So, the point to note here is, if the this Zener diode is kept under reverse bias condition and reverse bias potential is very high. Okay. Let us say that greater than Zener breakdown voltage. So, in that case, breakdown will take place in the Zener diode, and the potential which will appear across this Zener diode is actually Vz. Okay. that means the Zener breakdown voltage. Getting my point? What I am telling to what I am trying to tell you, that if let us say that 10 volt is applied here, okay, 10 volt is applied here, its Zener breakdown voltage is 5 volt. I mean breakdown is 5, takes place at 5 volt. So, only 5 volt will appear here, rest 5 volt will appear across this resistor. Okay. Similarly, if you apply 8 volt, so 5 volt will appear here, 3 volt will appear at the resistor, across the resistor. Okay. Just like the forward voltage drop of a diode. If a diode is kept under forward bias condition, we assume that there is a 0.7 volt drop across the diode. Similarly, for the Zener diode, if it is under reverse bias condition and a large reverse bias is applied, we have to assume that the potential drop across the Zener diode is equal to Zener breakdown voltage. Okay, getting my point. So, this is the VZ here, our Zener breakdown voltage, which will appear across the diode. Okay, because once the voltage goes above this, you see that for a very small change in the voltage, there is a very large change in the current. Okay. Just like the constant voltage drop model of your diode, okay, forward bias diode, okay, we will almost have the similar behavior here. So, this property is actually utilized, okay, to design a clipper circuit. What is done in this case is, we can have a resistor here and can use a Zener diode. Please note that when the Zener diode is under forward bias condition, its behavior will be similar to that of an ordinary diode. But in a reverse bias condition, its behavior is just we have to consider that the potential drop across the Zener diode is VZ. Okay. Now, let us look at this circuit. Consider that the breakdown voltage of both Zener diode is VZ. Okay. You can even have Zener diode with different breakdown voltages. In that case, you will get the asymmetric waveform, asymmetrical waveform at the output. Okay. I mean different amount of clipping in positive and negative portions of the waveform. But if you have the same breakdown voltage for both diodes, in that case, you will get a symmetrical waveform just like the previous case. Okay. So, what will happen in this case? You see that if a sinusoidal, let us say that sinusoidal potential is applied here as an input waveform, okay, between these two nodes, and this is our output, and let us say that the peak amplitude is E, the wave signal varies between plus E to minus E. And E is greater than VZ, okay, the breakdown voltage of the Zener diode. That condition should be satisfied here. Okay. So, what will happen for the positive peak, for the positive cycle of the input waveform? Let us say that the signal has reached to its peak value. Okay. So, what will happen at that moment? How these two diodes are going to behave? If the input signal amplitude is quite high, okay, greater than VZ, then you see that this diode will be under breakdown condition. Okay. So, the potential appear across this diode is going to be VZ. Okay. But what about this first diode? This will behave like an ordinary PN junction diode, which is under forward bias condition. Okay. That means the potential drop across this diode is only Vf, like this. Okay. That means one will be in forward bias condition, another one will be in the breakdown condition. Okay. So, potential now here is going to be Vf plus Vz. Okay. So, maximum output potential which is available here is Vf plus Vz. Okay. Vf plus VZ. The output level cannot go above that, okay, because in that case one diode will be in on condition, another one will be in breakdown condition, So the outputs remains fixed to this F plus VZ level. Okay. Similarly, think about the negative half cycle. What will happen if the signal reaches to this level? In that case, what will happen? Opposite thing will happen. Means now this first diode will be in breakdown condition and this one will be in on condition. Okay. So this one in on condition means the potential drop is now VF here, and the potential drop across this diode is now going to be VZ. Okay. Because this is now in under breakdown condition. Okay. And the total output potential in this case is going to be this minus VZ plus VF. Okay. So for positive half cycle, the output is maximum output is V naught VZ plus VF, and for negative output the maximum output is actually for the negative pulse the maximum output is minus VF plus VZ. Okay. That means even the input signal amplitude goes above VF plus VZ or below minus VF plus VZ. Okay. The output will remain fixed at V naught VF plus VZ and minus VF plus VZ respectively. Okay, getting my point. I consider this peak only because to ensure that the input signal, this diode is under reverse bias condition, breakdown condition. Okay. But the thing is, whenever this signal, the input portion tries to move above this VF plus VZ level, the output will be clamped, fixed here. Output level will be fixed. There will be no more change in the output. Okay. Is it clear or not? And similarly, when the input level goes below this minus VF plus VZ level, okay, there will be no change in the output because output will be fixed here across the two diodes. Okay. And what will happen when the input lies between these two, VF plus VZ and minus VF plus VZ? In that case, what will happen to this? This is under reverse bias, simple normal reverse bias condition. Normal reverse bias means off condition. Off means no current flowing in this branch. So since no current is flowing this branch, these two diodes are just broken out from the circuit. And in that case, whatever you apply at the input, that will appear at the output terminals. Okay. So when the input lies between VF plus VZ to minus VF plus VZ, the output signal will follow the input waveform, exactly same. Okay. But when input try to reach above VF plus VZ, output remains fixed at this level. And then again, when the input try to falls below this level, the output will follow the input. Okay. And this thing will be repeated even for the negative half cycle. Okay. So here you see that we have a clipper circuit which can clip both positive and negative portion. Okay. And as I told you that this is symmetrical clipper, that means this positive portion, anything above VF plus VZ is clipped up, anything minus below VF plus VZ is clipped up. Okay. If you select the different amount of breakdown voltage for both the diodes, if the breakdown voltages are different, then you will see that the amount of clippings are different in positive and negative half cycles. Okay. Depending upon the breakdown voltage of the diode. Is it clear? So this is all about a clipper circuit. Now we shall move to the clamper circuits. Clamper circuits. Or it is called DC restorer. Okay. DC restorer. That means a signal which brings back DC part into the input signal. Okay. For example, just take a sinusoidal signal, okay, like this. So, if it starts from, let us say, that minus infinity, goes to plus infinity, then if you take the average of this signal, you always find 0. Okay. If you take the DC part of this signal, that is always 0, because positive average will be cancelled by the negative average. Okay. So, this signal is said not to having any DC component in it. Okay. But if some DC is introduced in this signal, let us say that positive DC, then how this signal will appear? It will shifted up by the same amount of DC. Okay. That means if I add a DC part here, let us say that this is A max, okay. This is minus A max. If I add a DC in this signal, which has a amplitude, which has a magnitude E, then this signal will be superimposed on this DC. Okay. That means its variation now will be something like this. Its maximum amplitude becomes E plus A max, and minimum will become E minus A max. Is it or not? Okay. Now, if you take the average of this signal, you will find a DC component. Okay. If you integrate that signal over a time period, then there will be finite value because of this DC part only. Okay. So, this is the role of clamper circuit. A clamper circuit brings back DC part in the signal, okay, and as a result, signal is either shifted up or shifted down by certain DC magnitude. Okay. But when you look at the signal shape, it remains intact. Okay. That means if the for input signal, if the input signal variation is plus minus E, that means total variation is twice E in the magnitude. If the input signal variation is here twice A max, then the output signal will also have total variation of twice A max only. Okay. Subtract this E max, E plus A max minus E minus plus A max, E will be cancelled. Difference is 2 E max only. Okay. So, signal is shifted up or shifted down, but the signal shape remains intact, unlike the clipper circuit. Clipper circuit signal shape changes. In clipper circuit, signal shape is changed. Okay. But in a clamper circuit, signal shape will remain intact. Okay. Signal output signal will be the replica of the input signal. The only difference will be the output signal will have some DC part now. Okay. So, just like we had positive clipper and negative clipper, similarly we have positive clamper, negative clamper circuit. Okay. So, let me start with a negative clamper, positive clamper. So, circuit is very simple. We have a capacitor here and a diode. And a high resistance will be in parallel with the diode. Can connect it here. V0. Input has to be given from here. Okay. Please note that this resistor is the part of this circuit, it is not a load resistor. Okay. It is the part of this circuit only. So, I call it R1. Okay. And for the simplicity in the discussion, what I consider that the input signal is a simple pulse, positive and negative pulse like this. Okay. This is our expected, this is our input signal with the input level plus E to minus E. Okay. let us investigate how the which kind of output we are going to get here. Okay. So, just look at this diode and also see how actually it is connected. Okay. So, if you look at the connection of this diode, then you can easily say that when our diode is under forward, I mean for the positive input cycle, this is going to be under forward bias condition, is it or not? Because in that case, anode will be at higher potential than the cathode. Okay. So, in positive half cycle, basically what will happen? A current will flow, that since diode is under forward bias condition, and a forward bias diode offer very small resistance, as I have told you. Okay, very small resistance of few ohm. So, if it is so, then you will see that a current will flow in the circuit like this. Okay. What I did here, I neglected the current flowing through this resistor. Definitely there will be a very small current flowing because this is a large resistance connected here. Okay. So, large resistance, that is why I have neglected the current passing through this. What I consider here, the current passing through this capacitor is also passing, so same current is passing through the diode. Okay. This current is neglected. And because this diode is under forward bias condition and offering a small resistance, the charging of this capacitor will be done through this current. Okay. And in a steady state condition, this there will be potential developed across this capacitor. Okay. So, let us say that this potential is Vc, the capacitor potential. Okay. And you see that because this resistance R, which is required for this charging, it's actually we are talking about a RC circuit. The R is offered by this diode and the R of the signal source, which is in series with this. Which is in series with this capacitor. Okay. So, since the charging resistance or resistances are very small, the RC time constant is very small and therefore, charging will be done quickly. Okay. So, as a result, you will see that a potential will be developed across this capacitor, and what that potential is going to be after full charging, can you tell me? If this input level is maximum input level is E, okay. So, what will be the potential across this capacitor? E minus?
Yes.
Exactly. Because we have a potential drop here Vf. This was under forward bias condition. So, when this is under forward bias condition, our V naught is Vf for positive half cycle. Okay. For positive half cycle, V naught is Vf because the potential drop across this diode. Therefore, the potential here is Vf. At this point is E. So, the difference appears across this capacitor is the maximum potential up to which this diode can reach. Okay. So, the potential here is E minus Vf with the polarity shown in the figure. Okay. Why this polarity will be there? Because current is flowing in this manner. So, potential current always flow from higher potential to lower. So, that is why this is the polarity for the potential developed across this capacitor. Okay. So, this thing will happen in positive half cycle. Okay. Now, what will happen in the negative half cycle? When this cycle comes, this is for positive half cycle of the input. What happens in now negative half cycle? In negative half cycle, what will happen to the diode? Reverse biased. Why it is reverse biased? Because this node is already at higher potential E minus Vf. Okay. So, this until or unless the potential here is not goes below this E minus Vf, okay, this will be in off condition. So, in for the negative input cycle, this will be in off condition, and how much potential will appear now at the output terminal? Now look at this point, that capacitor is already having a potential E minus Vf, okay, and therefore the output potential can be calculated using a KVL equation. In negative half cycle, this is at minus, this one is at plus, and this potential is E, okay. So let me write a KVL here, E minus V naught, this is the reference direction for the output voltage, E minus V naught, then plus E minus Vf, plus E minus Vf equal to 0, okay. And you can see here that our V naught is basically okay, it is plus V naught, not minus V naught, is it or not? Because we are considering this polarity, okay, we are going from minus to plus. So this is plus, plus E minus V f equal to 0, and therefore V naught becomes minus 2 E plus V f, okay. Is it clear? So for the negative half cycle, the maximum output voltage is minus 2 E plus Vf, okay. So let me draw the output waveform now. For the positive half cycle, the output is Vf only, whereas for negative half cycle it is minus 2 E plus Vf. It is minus 2 E plus Vf, and then same thing will be repeated, okay. So you can think as if the signal is shifted down, okay, by a DC magnitude, because you see that the total swing in the signal is again Vf minus minus 2 E minus Vf. Vf, Vf cancelled, total swing is 2 E, okay. Total swing in the input signal is 2 E, but here you will see that average value will be quite small, okay. But in this case, if you calculate the average value of this signal, it will be larger than that of that signal, because this signal has more DC component compared to that one, okay. So this is called positive clipper, because the positive portion is clamped to Vf level. That means positive portion cannot go above Vf, that is the maximum level permitted for the positive portion. So it is clamped to Vf level, that is why it is called a clamper circuit, okay. It is clamped to Vf and full swing will be below this Vf, okay. Similarly, we can have a negative clipper circuit, and negative clipper circuit, for that you need to only reverse the direction of this diode this manner, okay. Please note that discharging, you can think of what will happen, okay. Discharging is actually not significant because of this larger resistance value, okay. If this were a smaller resistance value, discharging would have been very fast, okay. But because this is a large resistance value, there will be very small leakage of the charge from that capacitor, and we can think of that the capacitor maintains almost the same potential level, okay, even during the discharging period, okay. So that is why we get this kind of waveform. If there were some discharging from the capacitor, okay, the waveform would be here slightly tilted because of that discharging, okay. Getting this point? That means in negative half cycle, in negative half cycle, when the diode was off, the capacitor gets a path for discharging, this R1, okay. It is called bleeder resistance, because charge bleeds out, okay. So therefore, the potential here will drop from E minus Vf, there will be charging, but that charging will be very slowly. So due to that slow charging, what you will see that here you will find a tilting in the top level, okay. So even we can have a relationship for how much this tilting is done. If the change in potential is delta Vc, then we can write delta Vc equal to Ic into C by T, okay, if the T is discharging period. Ic into T, okay, so Ic into T by C. I into TQ divided by C is V. Okay. T is the discharging period. Okay. Ic is the discharging current through this resistor. Okay. So, if this is known, T is known, C is known, then you can find out this tilt in the output level during the discharging period. Okay. Now, let us do the negative clamper circuit. Okay, so, what I have to do? I have to change the direction of that diode. For the same input signal TV E to minus E, let us investigate what will be the output. Okay. So, as it is very obvious that this diode will be on only for the negative half cycle. Okay. So, in negative half cycle, this diode is going to be on and the potential drop across this diode is now Vf, okay, in this manner. So, when the input is in negative half cycle, our V naught is going to be minus Vf, okay. Output is clamped at this level. Output signal is not allowed to go below this level, okay. That is why it is called negative clamper. And you will see, let us see what will happen to the, for the positive half cycle. When the next positive half cycle comes, okay, and during this negative half cycle, the charging of this capacitor will be done, and now the potential develop across this capacitor will be how much? E minus Vf as in the previous case, but the polarity will be now different because the charging done in opposite direction. I mean, current direction was this now. Okay, current direction was this. Okay, so therefore, the capacitor gets develop some potential. Potential is developed across the capacitor with this polarity. Okay, and when the next positive half cycle comes, diode goes in off condition, and in that case, our output becomes for next positive half cycle. There is a potential drop across the capacitor, that is E minus Vf, and this is plus E. So, plus E plus E minus Vf, that is 2 E minus Vf is going to appear across this resistor. Okay. So, for positive half cycle, the output is E minus Vf plus E minus Vf plus E, that becomes twice E minus Vf. Okay. E minus Vf is across the diode, and E is the input signal amplitude. Okay. So, the output now becomes twice E minus Vf. So, in positive half cycle, the output level is twice E minus Vf. In negative half cycle, it is minus Vf. T, for positive half cycle, the input is twice E minus Vf, and for the positive half cycle, it is minus Vf. Okay. So, again you can see the total swing is 2 E minus Vf minus minus Vf. So, this Vf Vf cancelled out, it is twice E, just like the input signal. Okay. So, again the shape of the signal remains intact, there is no change in frequency, there is no change in the total input output swing. Okay. The only difference is the output signal has got shifted up. Okay. The minimum level is fixed, that is minus Vf, it cannot go below this minus BF level. Okay. That is why it is called negative clamper. Negative level is clamped to minus BF. In previous case, positive level was clamped to plus BF. Okay. So, that is why this is the thus this circuit actually clamps the input signal to a particular level. Okay. What to do if I want to clamp to a higher level? Let us say that for this case, okay, for the simplicity, let me take the positive clamper. So, this positive clamper, as you remember, it will clamp the output to the VF level, and then from VF to this was minus 2E plus VF. Okay. Now, what I want to do, I would like to have a higher clipping level, clamping level. You see that this is positive clamper which clamps the output signal to VF level. Okay. Now, I want to get a higher clamping level. I want to clamp it to a potential that is higher than that VF. Then what should I do? Can you suggest me something? I can use a battery in series with the diode. Okay. For example, if I connect a battery here in this manner, okay, how this is going to change this signal? Now, more potential is needed to make this diode turn on. Okay. And what will be that potential? Now, it will be VF plus this potential, battery potential. So, the potential here is going to be, now if the battery potential is, let us say, VB, then if the potential across between these two nodes goes above VB plus VF, then only it goes in on condition. Okay. And output clamps to that level. Is it or not? If I use a battery here, then the potential difference between two nodes should be greater than VB plus VF, then only it goes in on condition. Okay. And once it goes in on condition, the output level fixed to this potential plus this potential. Okay. So, in that case, this VF level will be shifted up, it will go here by VB plus VF. Okay. And similarly, this level will also go up by the same magnitude in such a manner that this swing will be twice E only. Okay. Got it. You can always use a battery either in series with this diode in this way or in the reverse way, okay, to get the different effects. Okay. In this case, you saw that the clamping level was shifted up by the VB, that means the potential offered by this battery level. Okay. Is it clear? Similarly, we can do the same thing for to have a lower clamping level in case of negative clamping, okay, just by connecting the suitable battery. So, that I am leaving to you as a home exercise. I do not want to repeat that again and again. Okay. Zener diode are also used for implementing the clamper circuit. Okay. That means, in place of battery, you can put a Zener diode. Okay. Because when Zener diode is under reverse bias condition, it behaves like a battery. It will have a potential drop across that Zener diode equal to that of the breakdown voltage. Okay. So, although it is not supplying power, but behaving something like a battery. Okay. So, if I replace battery by a Zener diode, it is going to work like the previous circuit. Let us see how. I am taking the same circuit, the capacitor here, then a diode, the resistor is always there, R1, then I am just replacing that battery by a Zener diode connected in the reverse manner. With its breakdown voltage Vz, okay. Its breakdown voltage is Vz, and the input signal is again the same square wave signal. It's not a square wave, only it is shown for one cycle, okay. But you can assume it to be repeated one, even for you can have second, third, fourth, and fifth cycle, and so on, okay. This is our input signal, the level R plus E and minus E, okay. So, for the positive half cycle, for what input level or what will be the level of this potential to start charging for this capacitor? Vf plus Vz, okay. Why? Because only Vf is needed to make this diode on, okay. But you need Vz, another Vz, to make this to push this Zener diode into the breakdown, okay. And once it goes into breakdown, even you apply higher potential here between these two nodes, the potential here across the Zener diode will be Vz only, okay, as I have earlier told you. Getting this point? So, for the positive half cycle, the output potential is going to be how much? Vf, that is the forward voltage drop across the diode, plus Vz, the potential drop across the Zener diode, okay. So, this is the maximum output level. The output level is clamped to Vf plus Vz, just like in previous case it was Vb plus Vf. In this case it is clamped to Vz plus Vf. And what about the negative half cycle? For this cycle, both will be in off condition, okay. And now tell me what will be this capacitor potential in the positive half cycle of the input. This was E, let us say. What will be the capacitor potential now? E minus Vf plus Vz in bracket, okay. So, the potential here becomes E minus Vf plus Vz, okay. That was the capacitor potential. And in reverse bias condition, when it is in off condition, both diode, you can assume that these two diodes are not in the part of this circuit, and in that case you can also find out the output voltage. What will be the output voltage in that case? In that case you can write a KVL here. KVL says that it is E plus V naught plus this, okay, plus E minus Vf plus Vz to be 0, okay. And thus I can solve this for V naught. V naught is minus 2 E plus Vf plus Vz, okay. Is it clear? So, if I have to draw the output waveform, I will draw it in this manner. You see that the maximum output level for the positive half cycle is Vf plus Vz only, okay. Whereas for the negative half cycle, we will have a waveform like this, okay. So, this is at Vf plus Vz, and this one is at minus 2e plus Vf plus Vz. Okay. So, the total swing is again 2E. Signal remains intact, no change. Signal shape remains intact. Okay. So, at the end, I would like to tell you that we can even implement digital circuits using the diodes. Okay. We can implement AND gate and OR gate, and let me very quickly finish this, tell you how we can implement AND gate and OR gates using diodes. Okay. A simple implementation for AND gate is here, so power supply, resistor, and let us do it for two input AND gates. Okay. So, we need two diodes here like this. The output will be taken between this node and the ground. Okay. This is at the ground, this is R, this is VCC. Okay. So, you know that for AND gate we have already, we had lot of discussion on AND gate. This for AND gate, if any input is 0, your output will be 0, okay. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So, here output will be 0, 0, 0. If both inputs are 1, then only output is 1, okay. Let us see how this is satisfied here. 1 means a high voltage level. High voltage level means the level of VCC, okay. If it is 5 volt, then our 1 volt level is 5. One logic level 1 is represented by 5 volt, 0 is represented by, let us say, 0 volt. Okay. So, if there is any 0 in the input, any 0 means ground, okay. Ground is 0. So, if there is any 0 here, that will ensure the diode in on condition, is it or not? Because you see the anode of both diodes are connected at VCC, 5 volt. Okay. So, whenever you put the cathode to 0, this diode goes into the forward bias, and if diode is under forward bias condition, then the output how much will be here? VCC? There is another way to write. You can start from here. This is at 0 level, and since this is under forward bias condition, this is Vf. So, potential here is Vf, okay, 0 plus Vf. So, Vf means 0.7, a very low voltage. Okay. That means, if there is any 0 either here or here, that respective diode will be in on condition, and that will ensure the output here to be 0 or 0.7. Okay. So, thus we get the these three conditions satisfied. Okay. Because Vf is 0.7, that is 0 logic. Okay. And then what will happen if both are in one condition? Both of one means if it is 5 volt, we have connected this to 5 volt and this one also to 5 volt. Okay. So, if it is 5 volt, then you see that anode and cathode are at same potential. So, this is in off condition because you need a difference of 0.7 between anode and cathode potential. But since both are at same potential, this is in off condition, similarly this is in off condition. So, if both are in off condition, then you will see what will be the current here? 0 current, no current will flow because this point is not connected to ground. So, since 0 current will flow here, whatever the potential here, that will travel to this node. Okay. So, in that case V naught become equal to VCC, thus it behaves like an AND gate. Okay. You can extend this circuit for 3 input AND gate, 4 input AND gate or like that. Okay. Similarly, we can implement an OR gate. This was AND gate implementation. We can also have OR gate implementation using diode. Let us do it for 2 input OR gate. This is ground, here we have to take the potential, okay. input 1, let us say A, B, and this is our Y. Okay. For OR gate, you know that if there is any input is high, the output will be high. Okay. If any input is 1, output has to be 1, is it or not? So, in this case, you can just check that out. If both input are, if any input is 1, let us say that A is at 1, means at high potential level, 5 volt. So, if it is at 5 volt, this diode will be in on condition. Okay. On means the potential drop across the diode is Vf, 0.7 volt. This is 5 volt. So, 5 minus 0.5, 0.7, here we will have 4.3 volt. Okay. 4.3 means output is at high level. Okay. Is it clear or not? And similarly, if this is 0, this is 1, so that will be in on condition, again we will have 5. Okay. When we will have 0 output? When both inputs are at 0. 0 means this is at low level, this one is also at low level, means both diode in off condition. Because when anode potential is lower than the cathode potential, or there is a difference less than 0.7 volt between anode and cathode, that has to be in off condition. So, this is off, this is also off, both are in off condition means there is no source of power supply, no potential is moving at the output, going to the output terminal. Okay. That means output is connected to ground and therefore output remains to 0 level. Okay. So, if both input are 0, output is 0. If at least one input is at 1, the output will be 1. So, thus we can implement OR gate. Okay. You can have 3, 4, 5 diodes in parallel and you can implement 3 input OR gate. Okay. So, with this we finish our discussion on diodes. Okay. As I have told you that you need to do lot of exercise, home exercise, because I have taken only 3 lectures on this. Ideally, I should have taken 6 to 7 lecture for this. Okay. However, if you will have any doubt on this topic, you can come to me, you can contact me. Okay. Thank you.